Hello everyone, this is Kerry Anderson. Hope you all doing well. In today's video, I'll be talking about the three imagrium instinct and how they can transform your life. So if you like the video related to manifestation power, I would like to request you all, please do subscribe the channel, hit the bell icon or give thumbs up so that I will come up with more and more videos with lots and lots of information. So here we begin, let's go. Are you ready to transform your life for the better? Learning about your Enneagram instinct can make your journey that much easier. You are born with three Enneagram instinct and you can't survive without them. There's the instinct that you really heavily on. Another is your strength and last is your blind spot. Discovering these instincts and learning how they transform your life can take you to the next level of consciousness. Are you ready to take the next step? Now here are the three Enneagram instinct that will transform your life. The first one is self-preservation. Self-preservation is a subtype concerned about the survival, safety, and well-being of ourselves and our family. These folks are often worried about having enough money, a safe and comfortable place to live, and access to medical care. People who identify with this subtype are always looking out for danger and making sure they are ready for whatever comes their way. When they sense danger, they look inward to solve problems. Self-preservation folks are in touch with their physical need. They notice when they are hungry and make sure they eat regularly. They make sure they go to the doctor and that their family members take care of themselves too. They make sure they have enough money and resource for their retirement, as well as making sure bills get paid on time. They want to make sure that credit card get paid down every month and that their family is spending within it means. Second part is the social. This subtype is always searching for groups and communities to participate in. It's important for them to feel part of a group and know their role. They are great observers and can discern who has the power to get things done. They take an interest in knowing the norms, procedures, and hierarchies of group that are important to them. This subtype has a particular orientation to people, social acceptance, honor, status, popularity, and recognition. They compare themselves to others and will sacrifice for a good of a group. When they are facing a problem, they look to the group to resolve the concern. Being in a social subtype doesn't mean they are extrovert. They can be an introvert and still place great importance on the group. For a social type, the group is always more important than the individual. The third part is sexual, one-on-one. This subtype is always looking for intimacy and intense one-on-one connection. When a person who identifies with a sexual subtype goes into a room, they are attracted to people with powerful energies. When they are with the other person, their attention becomes focused on that individual. They are connected energetically, emotionally, and mentally. People of this subtype like to show off like a peacock. They want to stand out from others and encourage reaction from others, so they are not overlooked. It's easy for them to feel alone, incomplete, and preoccupied about how others see them. They want to be beautiful and strong. When this subtype is in a relationship, they bring intensity and self-sacrifice into the relationship. They are always looking for their other half and they don't feel complete unless they are in a close relationship. When they are trying to solve problems, they look toward their primary relationship to resolve issues. People in the intense sexual subtype make sure they look their best every day. Discovering your dominant instinct, healthy instinct, and blind spot can help you become more balanced. Now, the noticing the strength of each of the three instincts can help you to notice how you show up in the world. So, how do you balance your Enneagram instinct? The first one is middle instinct. An excellent place to start is working on your middle instinct, which is probably your healthiest notice how you're responding to the world through this instinct. How are you benefiting from this instinct? What is still getting you in trouble? If your middle instinct is self-preservation, you probably take good care of yourself and your family. You eat well and get plenty of sleep. You make sure you have adequate insurance to prepare yourself for surprises that may happen. You prevent problems from occurring before they happen. If your middle instinct is social, you are in a group where you can excel. You make a great leader because you know how to bring out the best in others. You know how to get things done because you know who you need to get things done. You are not afraid to ask the right people for what you need. If your middle instinct is sexual, you're attracted to strong, healthy relationship. You don't get overly concerned about your looks. You can enjoy time alone and are not afraid to be in groups. Then it comes to the dominant instinct. For example, if you identify with self-preservation, you're probably over-concerned about your security and well-being. You probably also worry too much about all the possible things that could go wrong. Suppose you overdo your social instinct. You probably over-identify with the group and ignore your own needs. You will give away too much of yourself to meet the need of the group. You may feel insecure, always worried that you do not have enough power in the group. If you overdo your sexual instinct, you may be overly concerned about whether you are beautiful or strong enough. You will tend to compare yourself with others, always wanting to look better than others. You may also have a great fear of being alone. Then it comes to blind spot. If your blind spot is self-preservation, you probably forget you have physical, emotional, and mental need. You may spend more than you can afford. You may not be ready for your retirement. You may not eat well, causing you to have health problems. If your blind spot is social, you may be utterly oblivious to the impact you are having on the group. You may get in trouble for not respecting the norms and being blind to the needs of the group. You may act like Lone Ranger and cause a lot of irritation and anger. If your blind spot is sexual, you are at risk of getting into an inappropriate relationship, such as someone already married or too young. You will have powerful energy with little self-awareness, leading to an unhealthy and abusive relationship. Transformation through your instinct. Once you discern your instinct, you will better understand your Enneagram type. Now, that's all about the manifestation in this video. I hope you all liked it. So I personally prepared a small presentation that will be going to share in the description box below. Please check it out from there. So before signing off, I would like to request you all, please do like, share, subscribe this video with your loved ones so that they will also get to know better. So this is Kerry Anderson signing off. Please do take care of your health. I will definitely meet in the next video with my other content. Till then, God bless you. Bye bye and take care.